After the MLB passed down penalties to the Houston Astros on Monday, Alex Cora's seat got a little bit warmer in Boston with a cloud of uncertainty hanging over the team. Cora and the Red Sox mutually parted ways last night. Cora is out after two seasons as a skipper of the Sox, winning a World Series in 2018. Before his tenure in Boston, he was the bench coach for the 2017 Astros, where he won a World Series as well. Both teams are involved for sign-stealing schemes. Red Sox ownership and Cora met over the past couple days in Boston, and both agreeing with a new investigation into the Sox starting and Cora's Houston discipline looming over him, it will be best for Boston to move on. Another Sunday, another great matchup for NFL fans. 4:25 Sunday, it's an AFC title game rematch in Foxborough between the Patriots and the Chiefs. It's been a game of musical chairs to find out who will be kicking for the Patriots this season. And, well, who will be this weekend? Well, according to Ian Rappaport of the NFL Network, Nick Folk is expected to return and re-sign with New England. After workout Friday, he's reportedly good to go after his appendectomy. That clears that up, but it does explain Tom Brady's toe popping up on the injury report. Is Tom Brady the backup kicker on the depth chart?
Nope. That's not how I heard it. And I'm not the new kicker. We'd be screwed if I was the kicker. There's been a lot of urgency, I think, when we win and when we lose. This is a big one. It's on our schedule next. And it's a big challenge for us. So hopefully we can go out and meet a great challenge. It's going to be a great football game.
Being serious there, it should be a great matchup. Sunday, 4:25, Patriots-Chiefs in Foxborough. A win is a win, but there are some things to improve for PC, looking to fix some things after the win Saturday against St. Peter's. Tonight, a chance to do that against a Merrimack team that, even in its transition to Division I, already pulled off an upset this season. The Friars, though, getting a big boost, as in big man Nate Watson, the junior making his season debut, returning from a knee injury in the preseason. And the Friars need some big help on the offensive end early as the Friars' offensive woes continued. The Warriors jumping out to a 12-point lead. Jaleel Lord with the basket to make it a 22-10 Merrimack advantage. But here come the Friars. Watson made his presence known, helped spark a 14-0 run with the basket in the paint. Friars showing some life. That helped fuel the PC defense as well. The steal by Luan Pipkins, one of 11 in the game for the Friars, and he takes it back for two. Friars take a 5-point lead into the break. Second half, some flash to the rim for Providence. Pipkins up top to the big man, Watson. PC goes on another big run, 15-1, a big day for Nate. He had 14 points in 14 minutes in his return, and the run is capped off by a Pipkins triple. He was the leading scorer with 18. Providence wins 93-56.
Yeah, it definitely took a few minutes. The first 4 minutes was kind of tough, getting my breath back. But when I scored the first time, I just knew I was going to be ready again.
That run we picked up in the first half, it came off of Nate's intensity. Once he started making baskets, we picked it up, and then we started playing to our identity.
I was really happy to have Nate back out there today. You know, I mean, with his size, his versatility, especially around the basket, a physical presence, I truly believe he is the best post player in the Big East. I really believe that.
Oh, and by the way, a Merrimack player missed two straight free throws in the second half, so the entire Dunkin' Donuts Center crowd went home with free Chick-fil-A for the first time this season. The Pilgrim Patriot was out in the crowd tonight. They love their Patriots in Warwick. As Pilgrim was hosting Cherokee, we pick it up in the third quarter where Cherokee trailed 20-0 until this play. Zachary Boschwitz rolls out of the pocket and finds the wide-open John Haxson. Cherokee cuts the deficit to two possessions. Next Cherokee drive, Boschwitz takes himself this time, and here comes Cherokee. They cut it to just a 20-14 game, but Pilgrim kills the clock in their last possession and caps it off with this touchdown up top to Ethan Asadorian, who hauls it in with under 2 minutes to go in the game. Pilgrim holds on, 28-14 over Cherokee. That's sports. Thomas and Zarella, ABC 6 Sports.